idea of the Funders Collaborative wasn't simply for the foundations to pool their resources, but also to engineer other collaborations between neighborhoods that hadn't worked together, between small business owners who saw themselves as competitors. The foundations needed someone to run this new organization who understood how cities and communities work. And given the controversy surrounding the train, someone who also had the diplomatic skills of the United Nations Secretary. Jonathan Sage Martinson is the son of a Lutheran pastor and a former Peace Corps volunteer. Before becoming the first employee of the collaborative, he worked for a Central Corridor nonprofit focused on affordable housing and economic development in three neighborhoods. In his new role, he would do the same and a lot more for all 13 of its neighborhoods.
So when the Central Corridor became real, the funding was lining up. I was doing community development in these neighborhoods just north of the Central Corridor, and really all eyes were on that development because we knew it would have such a dramatic impact on those three neighborhoods. But we also knew it would change all 13 neighborhoods along the line, and really both cities in their entirety, to have this new light rail transit. I was intrigued because I knew what it would do to the places I was working, but because of the greater change for the city. So when the Central Corridor Funders Collaborative was launched, I applied for the job. And in the interview, I learned their main interest was helping folks learn together so they had the same information and could make decisions about how the neighborhoods would change along with the light rail. Seemed like a simple enough idea to me. Then when I was hired in June 2008, we fleshed that out a little bit with sort of a six-step process where we'd base the work on community-based plans in the corridor. We'd gather stakeholders who either cared about the issue or had the power to make an impact on that issue. We'd learn together, the kind of the foundation for the Funders Collaborative. We'd develop strategies, we'd implement those, and we'd measure results. It looked really neat on a piece of paper. And so then we thought we'd try it. And as you all know, who care about the Central Corridor, the first issue for us was on business mitigation. And if you also remember 2008, 2009, the tension was thick around business mitigation. And so I showed up with my piece of paper and the six-step process, but it wasn't always that neat. Just to give one example around the Business Resources Collaborative, where folks came together for businesses. Everyone agreed we ought to do something for small businesses. But everyone also disagreed on who should lead the group, and they weren't going to come if so-and-so was leading. So I spent a couple of months trying to find a neutral convener. Then we as a group had to get through the fact that the 13 organizations in the room had civil rights complaints filed against one another. There were lawsuits in federal court against one another, and learned to put that aside. And in the end, they did. Because the outcome, helping the small business along the Central Corridor, was a common enough agenda, and it really drove everyone to put everything else aside, leadership, other complaints, and really get the job done.